Hello and welcome to NewsClick. After weeks of intense rainfall, which led to flooding and huge human suffering, rainwaters are finally receding in Kerala, and people are beginning to leave relief camps. Now the next stage is rehabilitation, as well as an analysis of what actually took place. To talk more about this, we have with us James Wilson. Mr. Wilson is a special officer with the Kerala government in the Interstate Water Advisory Committee, as well as an expert on dam safety as well as water management issues. Hello, Mr. Wilson. Welcome to NewsClick.
Thank you.
Mr. Wilson, first of all, let's take a look at the criticism or the claim that actually Kerala was not really prepared for these floods. Was it possible to anticipate a disaster of this magnitude? And if so, what preparations were taken?
This type of events are called in our engineering parlance as one in 1,000-year events.
Right.
But that is a misleading term, because people will think that this type of a flood will happen only one time in 1,000 years. But the better way of expressing this in annual exceedance probability, you always, when you are designing a city, you are designing that particular city normally for 1 in 100 year flood.
Right.
1 in 100 year flood doesn't mean that it is only going to happen one time in 100 years. So the annual exceedance probability of that one is 1% of chance of having that particular flood in any year. So this type of flood, the chances in a 100-year span is 9.5%, 2%. So we had something similar to this one in 1924.
Right.
All data is indicating that Kerala had two major floods, one in 1924, another one was in 1961.
Yes.
So how much water at that time, because Periyar was one of the biggest river in the Kerala, and it is covering a large number of the areas. So we actually looking into the data, you can see that 1961 flood was almost 60% of the what we had in 1924.
Right.
So to prepare this one means that you need that much of resources for that particular thing. Second thing is that this is a very extreme event. Extreme event is happening, even your preparations has certain limitation into that world.
Right.
So there is a line. So many people doesn't understand that how Kerala's topography, these type of events has, however you are prepared, you have a problem with this type of particular things. We have a topographical concern. We are one of the width of the state is very narrow.
Right.
You are having 100 to 150 kilometer most of this. Slope is so huge, the water will gush. Most of the rivers, some rivers, it will be less than 20 hours from the origin to reach the sea.
Right.
So then we are having this Periyar system. Most when we are talking about the floods in Pamba, basically there was a flood happening many places. You look into that, and I can categorize that this particular flood has actually given so much insight into you, because you are having three type of systems affected by flood. Your Periyar is a moderately controlled river, because around 25% of annual rainfall you can actually trap in your reservoir. If you look into the Pamba, it is around 10.5%. So another systems of the places where we had huge issues called Calicut Nalambur, where the Chalia river is flowing, it has no dams.
Right.
There are another systems that is actually created havoc in Changanur and other places. This actually, the backwater from the Vembanad wetland was actually creating. Their three rivers doesn't have any single dam.
Right.
Achankovil, Manimalayar, and Meenachilar doesn't have anything. Pamba is having only a small reservoir compared with. I will, to get a perspective, I can tell you that Idukki capacity is 1460. The capacity of Idamalayar is 1020. The Pamba is around 445 MCM. Altogether, Kerala's capacity is around 5160. When you are looking into that one, you compare with Nagarjuna Sagar, that single reservoir can hold around 5600 MCM.
Right.
These all our these dams, 53 dams, plus we allowed Tamil Nadu to create four dams in our territory, that they are also storing around 670 MCM. Altogether, this, when you are looking into the average annual flow, these reservoirs can hold around 7% of the annual flow happening in our system. In a flood year, this normally this goes between 52, in certain levels it even goes up to 2.5 times of the average annual flow. So your capacity of this entire 7% was curtailed between 3 to 4%
right.
annual flow is actually trapped in your reservoir system. So as a flood control thing, you need sometimes reservoir, but the problem is that we are having three outlets also in the Vemayadu. One is Kayangulam Kayal, another one is at the Thottapalli spillway, and the Paravur Poli you are having at the Cochin area. So when you are actually going your reservoir with a huge area or flood absorption capacity, what will happen? You have to strike a balance between the money investment, that is, leave that apart. When you are creating huge space for flood absorption in that particular reservoir, you have to raise the reservoir level to a certain height. Some 20% capacity you want to keep that one. You have to remove that much forest from there.
Exactly.
So that there you are actually striking a balance. If somebody is accusing that Idukki doesn't have a flood storage balance, we created a flood storage space in Idukki. Around 10% of the, that was when government took a decision to discharge Idukki. Idukki's full reservoir level is 2403 feet. And we started discharging Idukki at around 2399. It is very closer to that one, 89, some 0.1 feet before. So Idukki can go maximum up to 240.85. But the thing is that if you are looking into that one, how much space we create? 10%. Beyond that one, if we are actually, no one predicted this type of a rainfall. You look into the advisory published by the Indian Meteorological Department on the 9th of August for 2 weeks. That doesn't speak about any type of a heavy rainfall in Kerala.
Right.
So that is the shortened rainfall. There is another advisory by the IMD for the August and September. They were talking that there will be 96% to 102%. That is their normal rainfall you are going to. That is for 2 months. That can be used for your short-term or medium-term management. You look into the entire IMD bulletin they published in the 30th November.
Right.
30th May. That is a long-term plan for the entire year. They never predicted it is not going to be a flood year. They only told that it is a normal year. It can, your rainfall, average rainfall, it can be up to 96% or 104%. For that long-term strategy, if somebody is advising us to empty your reservoir and keep in a normal year, because you need this water. The problem is, my acquisition is we are greedy. We are actually making power, and we are greedy to make power, money. We actually not ready to release this particular thing. There is one problem the people doesn't understand, that most of the Kerala's electricity boards reservoir systems are actually catering. The releases are actually used for small weirs and barrages downstream of that one. On the tailwaters are actually further used for irrigation project, and this water is actually used for drinking water purpose.
Mm-hmm.
So many wells are in the water authority are having. Even you are having this saline water intrusion is to a certain extent, this is helping that one. Look into Idukki. Idukki is having downstream of other Muvattuvuzha basin, you are having a Malangara. From that one, this entire Muvattuvuzha Valley irrigation project is flooded. Under the Kakki, you are having your Pamba Valley. You go to the Chalakudi, you are having Thumbur Mudi. This Chalakudi irrigation project is depending on this Sholayar and Poringalkuthu reservoir. Just like that one, that is an integrated reservoir operation. So we will suffer. Several times in Kerala, you are hearing that go to Shabarimala, you don't have any water to actually take a bath in this December period. So at that time, this KC reservoirs on the upstream are actually open. Without generative power, we are actually discharging there.
Right.
So this is a situation where, and another thing what we are noticing over the years, that when Kerala's average annual rainfall remains more or less constant from 1900 to this period for the last 100 years, we are experiencing a particular phenomenon that the number of rainy days are actually getting shorter.
Yes.
So you are having not a high rainfall, but moderate small spells. Previously, it was evenly distributed. That was actually getting skewed. So if we are not storing this particular water, and if this water is not there, you are going to have a problem with, forget about the power. First, your drinking water will be the bigger problem. You are having now the number of rainy days are shortened approximately to 80 days. The rest of the times, the lean flow, these rivers are not like Ganga or Brahmaputra, which receives the water during when the summer, when the glaciers are melting.
Right.
These rivers are not perennial rivers.
you are getting only non-perennial river, you are having a problem there. So these storages are very much essential. So the decision maker has to take a call,
right,
where you have to cut, where you have to release.
Right.
The biggest allegation we are facing is that between 2908, you would have been decided, you would have been actually started this control release or a trial run at 2398 feet, you could have been saved so much. These people doesn't understand the data. Between 2098 and 2099, hardly Idukki reservoir can store 0.5 TMC. How much spill it has? Idukki storage capacity is 51.5, effective storage capacity. Gross storage capacity is 70.5. The spill water is more than 30 TMC.
Right.
So if I created 0.5 TMC, whether it will make any qualitative difference in the entire management system? First question. Second question, when the chief minister took a decision on the 29th, I attended that meeting. We told that why we decided to have a trial run, because at that time the water was actually, we had a first peak, a heavy rainfall in the July middle that actually created havoc in the Kuttanadu. We were slowly recovering from that one. So when we are seeing that one, at that time the Idukki was receiving an inflow of around 25,000 cusacs. When the CM was calling the meeting, it was something around 16,000. After that, when we were waiting for to reach something around 2398, at that time it was something hovering between 2095 and 6. I don't remember exactly, but it is more or less there. But when we decided to release, do a trial run, why we decided to do a trial run? Because this reservoir last opened in 1992. So much encroachment happened in the last 26 years. If we are opening this particular reservoir, how the system is resilient, how many encroachment is there, whether it will create problems for the people in the immediate downstream, we decided to open that one. But we seen from that day till 8th of August, every day the rainfall was getting reduced, the right water flow into 16,000, it becomes around 3,700 plus. The inflow was reduced. So at that time, what we were doing, we were actually generating power at Moolamattam Power House and discharging this water. So if you look into the Idukki data, that is in the public domain, SLDC, State Load Dispatch Center published that one. You can see that almost 1 week, the water level in the Idukki is almost equal. Right. It was not fluctuating between 1 centimeter or 2 centimeter, something like that. Suddenly rain happened on the 9th onwards, but it was also slowly rising. What happened is actually reality is 15, 16, 17 is entirely changed the scenario. That is an uncontrollable flood. It is a 1 in 1,000 year event. I can say that somebody is saying it is today I had a discussion with some of the engineers in Central. Some agree with it 1 in 1,000 year, some agree says that okay, we can tell to 1 in 500, but that is small difference is there. Total rainfall event will be something like 50 millimeter or something. When you are going to the upper bound, you are going to have a small difference is there.
Right.
So I am calling it as a 1 in 1,000 year flood, which we had experienced something in 1924. There was lot of discussion is happening that IMD is putting that this is 164% of excess than whatever it is. That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Sense is that when I am putting some weight on your head, 25 kg for some 20 days, you will be able to, you have no problem.
Right.
Suddenly I put 500 kg on your 25 into 20, 500 kg on your head, your neck will break.
Exactly.
So just like that in the system is having its own resilience. You are, if we are getting this type of a rainfall for spanning for some 10 days, it would not
be
created any type of a flood.
It's a 3 days.
It is a 3 days. It is extreme rainfall. Can you believe that? I am having the data. Actually, I can tell you that how much it is. That is very interesting figure. You will then know that how severe this particular rain was. Because in 3 days, in Idukki, we got 576 millimeters of rainfall. That is, Idukki is used to get around 2,800. It is 1/6 of the annual rainfall. In 4 days, we got 811. It is almost more than 30-35% of the annual rainfall we are getting in Idukki happened within 4 days.
Right.
In 3 days, we had around that one. Pamba, you look into the Kakki reservoir, we had 915 millimeter rainfall in 4 days, and it is around 690 millimeter in 3 days.
Right.
So this is the situation. Kuttiyadi, that is in Calicut area. This Kuttiyadi reservoir, where this Acclaim is very close, that had recorded 954 millimeter. Right. You know that in Nilambur, when it was flooded, there was 410 millimeter rainfall in a single day. Mm-hmm. And Idamalayar, when you are reaching to the plains, it was little bit reduced, 644 right. in the Periyar Basin. Right. So, another peculiarity of this particular rain was, this is almost evenly spread all over Kerala. Mm-hmm. Today, I was sitting with the Central Water Commission engineers and we are looking into that one. We identified that there is a storm, Saiwas, Pirumedu. There, the 3 day was around 800. No biddy can, no system, whatever system you put. Right. You have to open that system and they are really appreciating the effort that how we are managing the system.
Right. So, if you look at, for instance, the IMD or the Central Water Commission, were there any steps they could have taken to provide better information?
No, the problem is that IMD also having certain limitations in these type of things. Mm. There are different type of natural calamity. If you are having an earthquake, we never developed a technology to predict that one. Only option with us is that to create structures resilient to actually withstand this particular type of a earthquake phenomena. Only a natural calamity which will give you a lot of time for preparation and evacuation is the cyclones. Hmm. That you know from 7 to 10 days in advance. At that time you can predict it with a 75% accuracy. When it is crossing to your coast very close, 3 to 4 days before, you are able to predict it between 95% to 97% accuracy. Right. So, you know the intensity of that one, you know which path it is going there, so you can evacuate people and you can get preparation. These type of extreme rainfall events hardly take 3 to 5 hours to actually damage. The storm will actually get intensified, then you know that. But whether this time is sufficient for to create any type of a response, I don't think that it is very difficult for any system in this type of a particular topography and this type of huge population density state is very difficult there.
Exactly right. And if you look, for instance, at the question of, say, the release of dams also, maybe could you take us through a small step-by-step, a very brief step-by-step procedure of how things worked out there?
Yeah, we are what we have done there in 14th B.C. seen that the rainfall is actually slowly intensifying. Mm. We are created a system, we are created a group to take a decision. We ensured a flow of information from all our dams.
Right.
Because if you are looking into the Periyar is having the biggest development of dams. I told you, Periyar is having around 25% of that river is in annual flow, we are dammed. Mm. Pamba is not that much, we don't have that much control over Pamba River. But in Periyar, we are having 14 dams by Kerala, 2 dams by Tamil Nadu. There are 2 weirs by Kerala and 1 barrage by Kerala. There is 1 weir by Tamil Nadu. That's a very this one. And it is having different type of tributary. In the main Periyar River, you are having upstream 1 Mulaperiyar reservoir controlled by Tamil Nadu. An uncertain element, nobody knows how much water they are going to release, when they are released. That is an uncertainty added into a very complex system of the Periyar. Then you are having a Idukki dam downstream, which is having a capacity of around 1460, one of the biggest capacity reservoir in Kerala. Below that one, some people are saying that why did not you fill that Lower Periyar reservoir? They doesn't know that what is the capacity of Lower Periyar and how it is managing, how it is, it is only having 4.5.
Right.
Every monsoon you see that from the June onwards, it will be, whenever there is a rain, it will overflow. This dam is only used for peak power generation, because without creating any storage capacity, it is only a runoff river scheme. Nobody in their right senses will
right.
tell that. Then you are having a Pudathankattu barrage. Somebody was coming in the TV and they were, why you are actually not filling Idamalayar reservoir. To fill the Idamalayar reservoir is not in the course of the main river. It is joining the Pudathankattu from other side of a tributary. That is upstream of that one. If I want to fill Idukki reservoir water to Idamalayar, I have to pump that water 200 to 300 feet from Pudathankattu barrage, kilometers and kilometers. They don't understand the system. Second thing is, you are having another group. If you visited Munnar, you can see that we are having 8 reservoirs there. one system is a weir, so forget about that, 7 reservoir systems. So, that is Kundala, Matupetti, Shengulam, Anerangal, Ponmudi, Kallarkutti, and there is an Arai Headworks. This system is a widespread area.
Mm-hmm.
This is one area where you had in 1924 flood, this Mudrapuda, it is called. Yeah. That area, entire road leading to Cochin to Munnar was washed away during the 1924 flood. But there we are having very limited storage capacity. Mm-hmm. When you are having 1460 in Idukki, it is having only 162.
Right.
Then you are having a small tributary called Perinyankutti, which is actually joining between Idukki and Mudrapuda. It is, the water is coming to lower Periyar, but it is having only two diversion schemes, small VS.
Right.
That doesn't have any storage facility at all. Then you are having the arm of Idamalayar. Idamalayar is having two dams upstream. One Veer and one dam. There is an upper Nirar Veer by Tamil Nadu government, and there is another one called lower Nirar. Below that one, you are Idamalayar. Idamalayar is having a control. You are having around 1000 mcm of water there. So this is a very integrated system.
Right.
So how we manage, you see, we ensured a flow of information. We put all district collectors in the group, all decision makers, top decision makers from the revenue addition chief secretary. He is the member secretary of the state disaster management.
Right.
And all these people were together, and district collectors, electricity board chairman, all chief engineers who are actually dealing with the power versus power generation, all chief engineers in charge of the dams.
Right.
And all engineers who are actually manning on the site on this dam. So we are getting flow of information, and
right,
we were looking, every hour we are looking that how this flow is changing.
Mm.
So if we are feeling that when, especially we are managing Idukki and Idamalayar in a synchronized mode.
Right.
Because if we are discharging that, if we are looking into that particular system in isolation, and I am not respecting the basin as a whole unit, because the entire system of water is actually getting into the Aluvai Cochin belt. So I am seeing that whether if I am releasing more, sometimes I am releasing more, Idamalayar, I will allow Idamalayar to go little bit up.
Right.
That time I want to reduce some water, and I am creating some space in Idukki. So just like that, we actually manage that one. So that was a very complex management. Every
exactly.
hour engineers were stressed
right.
to their minimum. Nobody was sleeping at all. People were hardly slept for 3 days. There was nothing sleep. 14th onwards till 17th. I seen that my chairman has, I was really surprised. He's a administrator. He is also taking the pain that he was actually in the group. Even 2 o'clock, sometimes I get sleepy. Second day or third day, I got sleepy. Then he is asking me that, what is your suggestion about Idukki? Because we are getting, so many people are saying so many things.
Right.
So they are getting suggestion from people, and they are taking quick decisions without
exactly.
considering. Because our chief minister, when he made a review on 29th, he given us that, okay, this is situation, now it is your choice.
Mm-hmm.
You do what situation demands.
Right.
Don't come back to me for every single decision.
Mm-hmm.
So he given the freedom to professionally manage the tool.
Mm-hmm.
He knows that a political decision will be taken at that level. After that, it is our job
right.
to manage this one.
Right.
We think that we are not going to face this in our lifetime. Everybody rose to that occasion, and they managed at their, they were stretched to their limits. Some people actually had in Pamba, Kakki and Sholayar areas, they had airships. You know, people were actually stranded there, engineers were stranded there for without food for 2 to 3 days.
Okay.
But they were not, they are still managing, they are getting, we are actually messaging them through some other means.
Mm-hmm.
They are getting, luckily in Kerala, most of the, if you go to any remote place also, you will get a cell connectivity there.
Mm-hmm.
Only for a couple of hours, Idukki lost the entire cell phone problem because of the flooding and other things. Otherwise, we were getting, flow of information was there,
right.
assured.
Right.
But one big lesson I am learning that, now we are having satellite phones and other things, so we will give to these type of people who are there.
Right, at the stations. Right. Thank you so much, Mr. Evans.
Thank you.
That's all we have time for News Click today. Thank you.